Mourners at the burial of Sarah Nyirabashisi Mateke, the late State Minister for Defence and Veteran Affairs and woman MP for Chisoro District, were filled with excitement as local NRM leaders endorsed her sister Ruth Nyiraneza as the ideal candidate to fill her position. This decision was first proposed during a district council session on Wednesday at the family home in Bugahe Village, Nyakabingo Parish, Chahi Sub-County in Chisoro District. During the burial yesterday, the Chisoro LC5 chairperson Abel Bizimana confirmed the endorsement, stating that Nyiraneza is well positioned to continue the work that Mateke had planned before passing.
We have decided that this last moment of the term Sarah was trying to finish be selfishly guided in solidarity with the family of Mateke to Nyiraneza Ruth, so that she can complete that part and the rest will follow the next time.
John Nezimana Kamara, the Bufumbira North MP, later introduced Nyiraneza, asking her for affirmation of the leadership decision. Sparked with excitement, the mourners agreed to support Nyiraneza.
Those people who say that this is correct,
Dr. Bario Munsi emphasized that while the people of Chisoro had made their wishes clear, the NRM would still follow its constitutional processes in selecting the next woman MP for Chisoro District.
And the voice of the people is the voice of God. So we receive your resolution with respect, but at the NRM, we shall later, when the Electoral Commission has guided us on the steps, convene an extended district NRM conference.
The second season of the Ultimate University Quiz, organized by Vision Group, was launched yesterday at the Central Bank headquarters in Kampala. The competition, which aims to stimulate the minds of tertiary students, will feature 16 universities competing in economics and other subjects. While launching the competition, the Bank of Uganda Deputy Governor Michael Atingego emphasized its importance in preparing Uganda's youth for the future.
While shaping the future, to our participating students, you are the lifeblood of this nation's future. Your enthusiasm, your intellect, and your dedication do inspire all of us. The challenge is your platform to shine, like has been said, to demonstrate not just what you know, but also what you think.
Vision Group Managing Director Don Innocent Wanyama highlighted the objectives of the competition.
We seek to establish a prestigious academic competition that challenges and rewards university students for their knowledge. We also seek to encourage a culture of research, reading and learning among students. We want to use this quiz to enhance corporate social responsibility by helping shape well-rounded, confident students who benefit from this quiz.
He further revealed the enhancements that have been made to spice up this year's competitions. The winning university will receive equipment worth 25 million shillings, while the winning students will receive 1 million shillings and laptops each. The second and third place winners will also receive equipment and gadgets. With Stanbic Bank and UCC as new partners, as well as enhanced prizes, this year's competition promises to be an exciting experience for participating students. Controversy erupted in the Henry Katanga murder trial yesterday, 12th of September, as Uganda Police's Director of Forensic Services, Andrew Mubiru Kizimula, faced serious allegations. Mubiru was accused of conducting DNA analysis without proper authorization, which, according to the defense, breaches Uganda Police's standard operating procedures. Defense lawyers led by Elijon Karuhanga argue that the Uganda Police is only authorized to perform DNA tests for determining parentage and not for criminal trials.
I suggest to you that under the Uganda Police Standing Orders Volume 2, crime and CID, you are not allowed to conduct DNA testing.
You have no authorization to test the DNA of anyone except finding out who my father is and who my mother is.
They allege that Mubiru overstepped his authority, traditionally held by the government chemist, for criminal cases, and suggest that his actions could have been manipulated to produce biased evidence in the favor of the Director of Public Prosecutions, DPP.
So, you can confirm that before this letter, you were already conducting forensic DNA testing services.
Yes, my lord.
The lawyers highlighted discrepancies in DNA report, which was cited in a court summary from February 2024, but was signed in April 2024. They also accused Mubiru of a pattern of manipulating DNA reports, referencing a past case where he was found to have included an unauthorized sample.
It is abundantly clear that the Directorate of Forensic Services operated as a kitchen that cooks evidence and not as a lab that finds it.
The trial has been adjourned to September 26, 2024 for further hearings. The accusations cast a shadow over the integrity of forensic evidence in the case.